do you see? I should not be seen in this area.
To the keep now.
I wonder what in God's name we're here for.
There now, my lord. All is prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Elderman?
Your Elderman is long past the days of good conversation.
Yet still he makes good company. I've been instructed to wash and prepare his earthly vessel.
Instructed by whom?
Soldiers. They brought him here as he protested, feebly. I did my best to make him comfortable, until He slipped away.
Why has your Elderman's death been obscured? The people of Lincolnshire deserve to know his fate, Quimbald above all.
When the guards put him in my care, I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I've seen all I need to, but Quimbald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects, though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve your purpose.
I'll find something. I don't know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes, I thought the same. Troubling.
Foul. Rat droppings everywhere.
Even in death, my lord is a friend to all of God's creatures.
Dried herbs and berries, crushed into powder.
The time between my lord's departure and his burial is longer than usual. My lord must keep up appearances for his upcoming rites.
A box of musty clothing, and a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do. I'll return this brooch to Quimbald in Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news. Your father's dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Humbjord's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone. He...
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer! Do you hear me? I am a man, and I am my father's son! Do not forget it!
Keep steady, Quimbald. You're now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain. Last in a line of dwindling nobles.
I'm sorry, Quimbald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Quimbald was the son of an elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot, but between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convene.
Someone in the shire wants Quimbald dead. If I have to assemble an army to make sure this meeting is not an ambush, I will.
The shire moot is a lawful, godly assembly. Quimbald will be safe, as will you be.
Apart from Quimbald, who else will stand for the ultimate seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this Shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land, and I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my...
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Humbioth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archie went to console him. I should follow her.
Archie, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
I have better people to speak to. Wallow in your self-made grief, Ebbers.
Go then. Why linger here? I must beg forgiveness from my God. The Lord lifts up the meek. We must praise him.
You to shut your flappers! You're finished! Be gone! This prisoner comes with me! Let's spill some in it! They said a Dane would like... Untie me! Quickly!
Seems there is a bounty out on Hunwald.
Oh, he's ruffled some feathers, that much is clear. Do you know him?
I do.
Then the Lord truly is watching over me.
Right place, right...
Thanks for saving my neck, stranger. I pray I can return the favor someday.
Show me what lies ahead.
These woods, father. Oh, these woods.
Hello? Eivor? Is that you? Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate. Contemplate the view.
Be easy with your grief, Hunwald. If you're not careful, it's a poison you'll bear in your blood for the rest of your life.
No need to worry.
For I have found the antidote for it.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness, but let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To you, Hunwald. You have love in your heart and hope in your eyes. That's more than many can say.
Eivor, I can't begin to...
All right, Lord. You are all right. Skål!
Skål! And then my father says, it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humor, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right, your Dane lady love. She sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Now come, and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You've never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords, like a giant's axe wound. Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter. Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You can't grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect her. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced. But I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be the poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course. But give me that chance. My God, I just want to have that chance.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor! Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Shh. Quiet. Stop here. Something isn't right. I'll find the trouble before it finds us.
Hide a fight, Hunwald! Now!
Father, give me strength to survive.
Shoot it! Feel my breath on your neck!
options, Jock.
That's twice they've tried to kill you.
And twice failed.
We had luck. But if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead. And they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I'm serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Elderman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy.
Yeah.
To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself. Looking for someone?
My husband. He was not supposed to leave home on his own. I fear he has fallen asleep somewhere.
Fallen asleep?
Yes. A curse he has carried his whole life. At any moment, his eyes roll back and his body simply collapses.
Dangerous to be out there on his own. Do you think he would have gotten far?
His bag is gone. I fear he may have taken it to go fruit picking down south near the old ruin. Bjarti, where are you?
I will keep an eye out for him.
Thank you. He snores, if that helps.
Follow my voice, Bjarti!
Oh, thank the heavens! There she is!
Hunwald, I thought for sure you'd...
Ah, yes! I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here, out of sight, until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. This Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
Rest, Hunwald. By sunrise, you'll have shed all your tears and pissed out the last of the ale.
Eivor is right, Hunwald. Tomorrow is a new day.
Yes. Yes, resting next to my angel will heal all that is broken within me.
Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I don't doubt it.
My dice hand is itching for a challenger. Today might be your lucky day, Dane.
Ah, Orlok.
Fortune, you are pretty good.
That isn't...
I'll take on all comers!
course not. No, no, no. I'm just resting my eyes. I swear it.
Lucky it was me that found you. Me on a good day, I may add. It's not enough that you are dead weight. I have to listen to your babbling as well.
To touch me there. With the big nose, not me.
I found him asleep beneath a tree.
My poor Bjarti. I'm so glad he's all right. You saved his life.
Luck was with him. No hungry wolves or roaming bandits. The note he carries is helpful, but he must have more caution. He may not be so lucky the next time.
You're right. I will wait until he wakes. And when he does, I will belt him.
That is a start.
I was filled with worry. I can hear you. You're all right.
Kya!
Oh, my God. How do I get through another night without you?
Those are the cries of a broken heart. Who died?
My beloved cat, Sphinxy. And please, do not be so crass. Sphinxy has simply passed on. She is in God's hands.
Nothing hurts quite like a fresh wound. But in time, it will heal, and life will return to normal.
Oh, if only. Instead, I find myself missing her more and more, with each passing winter.
How long ago did Sphinxy pass on?
11 years ago tomorrow. A long time, I know.
A little. Have you thought about honoring Sphinxy with a shrine? It is no burial, but it may ease your grief.
I am halfway there, but I cannot bring myself to sort through her things. I simply do not have the strength.
You alone must find the...
True words. I shall try.
Still...
What else can I do?
I will help you.
My home.
Something I can find in here for the cat's shrine. If I can sort through all the rubble, I will add this to the shrine. This will do. I've found some of Sphinxy's belongings. It is done. A shrine dedicated to Sphinxy. Whenever you care to pay your respect, and a home you can return to again. It may take some getting used to without Sphinxy, but her children need you.
And here I thought all Danes were ruthless plunderers. Murderers! You have a soul that would grace the heavens. Light my Sphinxy. Lord, light your way.
No!
Easy now. I'm right.
Yeah.
You two again. Bent over the barrel of another adventure, I see.
This is his fault. I told him they looked like bandits, but he insisted on cheating them out of coin. We need to leave. Some of them went to fetch firewood. They will be back any moment.
There is no we in this. Your brother, your problem.
What? No, please. Look at him. He is dead weight.
Dead weight soon. You should hurry.
If I have to carry him, we will never make it out of here alive. Please.
Zunin, guide me.
Think again, Saxon filth. There is no besting these sons of Ragnar. Soon the world will know us by name.
A sleep talker. Just what I needed.
See this? Do you see it? This blade was forged by Grundle. Grundle Thundersmith. Greatest of all blacksmiths. One nick, and your life essence will shoot out of you like a geyser from the depths of Norway. You laugh. Am I a joke to you? Do I look like a jester? That is what I thought. You will think again before laughing behind my back. No one laughs at me. No one.
Cast him aside when this is done, for your sake.
Thank you.
This is where we part ways.
Yes. My thanks. Thank you.
Stop thanking me and listen closely. This life does not suit you. There are people out there who would kill you over these petty squabbles.
This I have realized.
If your idiot brother hatches another one of his glory-seeking plans, take your fist and slam it right between his eyes. Or better yet, punch him in his cock.
Punch his cock. Yes. That should get the point across. Thank you. You will never s-
Good.
What?
What? What is?
Ah, we made away with the coin, didn't we? Poor fools never suspected us. But we are more clever than we look, eh? Where are you going, brother? You must tell the details of this great victory.
I am going home.
Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Elfgard. It's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
If this belonged to the elderman, shouldn't it go to Hunwald next?
I suppose so. But I thought you a more fitting recipient. You'd know how to use it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moots. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear?
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is all but ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. Today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
Sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herifriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damned decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified, not of being raided, but of their spouses being seduced away with all your perfumes and braiding and grooming and bathing even. How novel.
I hear you Saxons bathe once a year, whether you need it or not.
That's true.
Are we hunting, Elfgard? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby. Ah, my old friend Grim. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt, as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right, very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
It is good to meet you, Grim.
Hail, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Elfgard claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we?